Having passed through the 9th division of the Tuat, the boat of the sun arrives at the 10th division, which is passed through by the sun during the 10th hour of the night. The opening text reads, "This great god taketh up his place in this circle, and he uttereth words to the gods who dwell therein." The name of the door of this city through which this great god entereth is Akurpamesaru. The name of this city is Metet Ka'achubu. The name of the hour of the night, which guideth this great god to the hidden paths of this city, is Tentanet Yuhit Kakabu. In the middle register are 1. The boat of the sun, in which the god stands under a canopy formed by the serpent Mehen. He holds the symbol of life in his right hand, and a serpent, which serves as a scepter, in his left. 2. A large two-headed serpent called Vesrau, which is depicted in the form of a pair of horns deeply curved towards the ends where they meet. The head which faces to the right has on it a white crown, and is directly opposite to the face of a goddess, who also wears a white crown, and is called Hurt-Urmint, and the head which faces the left has on it a red crown, and is directly opposite to the face of a goddess, who also wears a red crown, and is called Shemerti, i.e., she of the two bows. The serpent is provided with two pairs of legs. One pair is turned to the right, and the other to the left. Within the curve is a large hawk, which bears the name of Herakenti. 3. A boat, wherein lies at full length the serpent Ankhtar. 4. Four male figures, each of which has a disc in place of a head, each grasps in his right hand an arrow, with a spear-shaped head, which rests on his shoulder, and is pointed downwards. Their names are 1. Tephra. 2. Shisera. 3. Tamal. 4. Utu. 5. Four bearded, human-headed figures, each of which has in his right hand a short spear, which rests on his shoulder, and is pointed upwards. Their names are 1. Setu. 2. Urtau. 3. Kisfu. 4. Sekenyu. 6. Four bearded, human-headed figures, each grasping with both hands a bow, which he holds above his knees. Their names are 1. Hetti. 2. Shemurthi. 3. Fisu. 4. Ka'a. The texts which refer to the above read, "This great god makes his journey through the city, in this picture, in his boat, and his sailors, who are the gods, convey him along. This great god taketh up his place in the city in the water, whereupon those who live in the water make use of their weapons, and they spring into life at the sound of the working of the sailors, who are gods, in the boat of Ra. Those who are in this picture are they who are on the two sides of Vesrau, who is the soil of Sekri, the governor of the Tuat. This figure, i.e., the serpent, even in the form in which it is, traveleth after this great god into its horizon, and it entereth in with him in the earth every day. He who is in this picture in his boat stands up in the thick darkness in the hall of the eastern horizon, and he takes up his position in his place every day. He forms the serpent watcher of the Tuat in the holy place of Kenti Amenti. To those who are in this picture with their arrows, and to those with javelins, and to those with their bows, who are in the presence of this great god, and who make their appearance with him in the eastern horizon of the sky, this great god says, speed ye your arrows, make ready your javelins, bend your bows, and destroy ye for me my enemies who are in darkness, be ye at the portal of your horizon, and follow ye in my train when I unite myself to those who make adoration to my flesh in the Mantit boat. It is they who drive back the Sebi serpent of Neha Ra in the thick darkness, and when this great god passes on into the eastern hall of the horizon, they also travel on in the train of this god. Over the upper register runs a line of text, which reads, this is the hidden circle of Amentet, where Keeper unites himself to the form of Ra, and where the gods, and the spirits, and the dead hasten in the hidden forms of Akert. If a copy of these things be made according to the figures which are depicted on the east of the hidden chamber of the Tuat, and if a man knoweth it, together with the names of the gods, he shall journey round about, and shall pass through the Tuat, and he shall not be turned back from making himself a companion of Ra. In the upper register are 1. The god Punki, who holds an ankh in his right hand, and a scepter in his left. 2. A beetle, called Keeper Ankh, apparently pushing along a zone of sand, or perhaps entering the horizon. The text which refers to these scenes reads, "Those who are in this picture in the Tuat are in the forms of, i.e., they represent, the births of the God-keeper, who is carrying his horizon to this city, so that he may come forth into the eastern horizon of the sky. Two serpents, standing on their tails, which cross each other near their tips. Their heads and necks are bent at right angles to their bodies, and in the space between them rests a disc. The serpents are called Menenoi. To the right is a youthful goddess wearing a white crown, and to the left is a similar goddess wearing a red crown. Each holds the index finger of one hand to her mouth, after the manner of children, and each is depicted in the act of sitting, but lacks a seat or throne. An axe, symbol of God, standing on the handle end, with a disc resting on the side edge of the head. On the left is a goddess who is steadying the axe with her left hand, and on the right is a goddess who is steadying the disc with her right hand. The names of the goddesses are Nefeth and Kanat, respectively. Each goddess is depicted in the act of sitting, but lacks a seat or throne." The text which refers to these scenes reads, "Of those who are in this picture, the two goddesses on the left come forth from the double serpent Menenui, and the two on the right come forth from the axe Setfit. They gather together the souls on earth, and they make pure the mighty spirits in the Tuat by the hidden figures which are therein, and afterwards they swallow their own spirits, or souls, after this great god hath passed them by. 5, 8 goddesses, who stand upright, and hold an ankh in their right hands, and a scepter in their left, they face the 8th god, whose tail is stiffened out under him in such a manner as to form a seat for him, and who holds the Etchet, or Eye of the Sun, on his 2 hands. The first 4 of the goddesses have each the head of a lioness, and are called 1. Sekhet, 2. Menkert, 3. Hunkath, 4. Usrit. The remaining 4 have the heads of women, and have the names of 1. Amt Netterer S, 2. Eret Tafith, 3. Ahat, 4. The Math Ermin. The name of the 8th god is Af Ermin Madef. Concerning the goddesses, the text says, "To these goddesses who make the reckoning of his eye for Horus in the Tuat, Ra Seth, make ye strong your spirits by means of your strength, and make the reckoning of his eye for Horus, establish ye his eye for Horus, and make ye Horus to unite himself to his emanation, or to that which flow from his eyes. Praise ye Horus by reason of his eye, and establish ye his first eye which is in the hands of the god Af Ermin Manef. And utter ye your words on behalf of Horus, O ye who cause to come into being the becomings of created things. The work which they do in the Tuat is to utter words on behalf of his eye for Horus, and to cause radiant splendor to proceed from it each day. 6, 8 gods, each of the first 7 of whom holds an ankh in his right hand, and scepter in his left. Their names are 1. Ermenui, who has the double object in the place of a head. 2. Nebeket, jackal-headed. 3. Amenpu, hawk-headed. 4. Hershadet, Shadetawi, man-headed. 5. Semheru, man-headed. 6. Amenheru, man-headed. 7. Kent-Astef, man-headed. 8. Kent-Mendef, a god in mummied form, like Osiris, who wears a white crown, and grasps a scepter, with both hands, which project from his bandages." The text which refers to these gods reads, "Those who are in this picture in the forms which Horus made when this great god cries out to them by their names, they unite themselves, and come into life in the shades which are in the mouth of the great god, and their souls journey onwards in his train to the horizon. They strip the bodies of the dead of their swathings, and break in pieces the bodies of the enemies of Ra, and they give the order for their destruction in the Tuat. In the lower register are 1. The god Horus, hawk-headed and wearing a disc, leaning on a staff. 2. 5 lakes of water, in each of which is submerged a male form. These figures are called the submerged. 3. 3 lakes of water, in each of which is a male form swimming, turned over on his breast. These are called the swimmers. 4. 4 lakes of water, in each of which is a male form floating on his back. These are called the floaters. The above text is full of lacunae, and whole passages, consisting of several lines, are wanting. The following version from Lanzone's edition, Le Domicile de Esprits, PL2, will be found useful in obtaining an idea of the contents of the legends which accompanied the lakes of water. Horace saith unto those who have plunged themselves beneath the waters, and unto those who swim, and unto those who float in new of the tuat, O ye who have plunged yourselves beneath the waters, who shine in new, O ye whose hands cover your faces, who swim with your faces turned towards the water in the tuat, whose cheeks are filled with water, O ye who paddle in the waters of new, whose faces are turned up into the air in the following of your souls, whose souls have been deprived of their heavenly air, and who beat the air with your hands in order to obtain it, O make ye your way new by means of your legs, and your thighs shall not be in any way impeded. Come ye forth in this stream, descend ye on these waves, fill ye Hapur, and arrive ye at its furrows, for your members shall not perish, and your flesh shall not decay, and ye shall have dominion over your water, and ye shall have abundance according to my command, O ye whose duty it is to dwell in new, together with those who have plunged themselves beneath the waters, and are in his following, and whose souls have life. 5. A lake of water. 6. Four female figures, each bearing a serpent on her head and shoulders. The head of each reptile is raised above the head of its bearer, and its tail hangs down her back. Their names are 1. Hedamit. 2. Bekhagit. 3. Chetmit. 4. Synthes. The text reads, those who are in this picture are they whose forms, or figures, live by their heads. It is they who shed light upon the road of Ra in the thick darkness, and when he comes forth into the hall of the east, Set wakes up and travels on with him. 7. A scepter, surmounted by the head of Set. Its name is Set Nehes, i.e., Set who wakens.